Hello dear bonsai friends, I'm Peter. Welcome to my bonsai channel. In this video, I've tried to understand my and maybe your problems with watering bonsais and of course other potted plants. In my garden I keep about 500 bonsais and pre-bonsais with about 100 different species and many different demands and potting soils. Unfortunately, I have lost some beautiful trees in my bonsai care during the last years. I attribute most of the losses to waterlogging. On these pictures, you can see typical damage caused by waterlogging on these cotton asters. Only by immediate repotting or drying, bonsai could be saved. This bonsai, for comparison, is completely healthy. Also, with these pip straps, the wetness damages are to be recognized. I have tried different bonsai soils. I have so far rejected a purely mineral substrate because I cannot guarantee sufficient watering of my bonsais at any time, especially in dry weather conditions. Up to now, I have considered good drainage to be particularly important. My experiments are, of course, for orientation. I am not a scientist. During my experiments, I came to very surprising results. First of all, you take three bowls and a pot as a container. In the higher pot and one bowl, I fill the same amount of simple garden soil. The next bonsai pot is Akadama. And the last one is a mixture of 60% fire clay beads and 40% peat. Next, I weigh the individual containers with the dry earth. Then I water the pot and the bowls extensively. What do I notice afterwards? All substrates drain very well. After a certain time, no more water runs off. This means that the soils have reached their maximum saturation with water. From this point on, the reduction of the water content is only done via the surface or via the consumption of the plants. Weigh in this state results in a weight increase as follows. Akadama plus 25%, that means about 300 milliliters additional water content. Clay peat mixture plus 60%, about 490 milliliters of water. Incredible. Another surprise. Garden soil in the flat bowl plus 52%, this is 580 milliliters of water. And the garden soil in the high pot plus 37, These are about 390 milliliters of water. With the same volume, a flat bowl can absorb considerably more water. Why? My explanation, I hope it makes sense. The water in the earth has the highest concentration in the lowest area due to the water pressure. This particular volume is much smaller in the high pot. For me now, the fact that the problem of waterlogging after repotting from high pots into flat bowls increases significantly. Thus, the introduction of gravel for drainage now bring an improvement? I don't think so. Because of this, the maximum water saturated layer is only moved upwards. This is closer to the root area and therefore a higher risk of rotting. In addition, the fine earth particles sink down between the gravel over time and only shift the maximum saturation area slightly downwards. Back to my attempt, after 3 days, always 20 degrees Celsius, hardly no wind, no precipitation, and full sunshine. Stay healthy. One important factor, in full sun, the bonsai shells heat up by additionally 20 degrees Celsius. The darker the color, the more. How much moisture is still in the shells after 3 days? Akadama, only 3% left. That means only 30 milliliters water content. Clay-peat mixture, still 11%, 110 milliliters. Now the garden soil again, and the flat pot still 9%, 100 milliliters. In the high pot, there are still 60%, 180 milliliters of water. I see, but easy to explain. The flat pot has a much larger surface area, so evaporation is much faster and larger. These values are, of course, only to be seen as an orientation. A plant would accelerate the drying process even more, depending on the plant variety and the foliage. Now the question arises whether there's a possibility to delay the drying out a little if you can't water the bonsai for a few days. For this purpose, I place the bonsai bowls in the full shade for 3 days after watering them under the same weather conditions. A clear difference. Akadama still has 180 milliliters of water. The clay peat mixture still has 390 milliliters. The garden soil and the flat bowl still have 320 milliliters. And in the high pot, 220 milliliters. In the shade, surface evaporation by solar radiation obviously does not play such a decisive role. The result for me, in order to survive long rainy periods here in Bavaria, without damage to my bonsai, I now put wetness sensitive plants in a bonsai soil with a lower maximum water content. For this, I reduce the organic content. Depending on the climate you have and the bonsai you cultivate, this can of course vary. Be curious, I'm happy if I may share my modest knowledge with you. Please leave a comment, thumbs up if you like it. Subscribe to my channel to be notified when there's a new video. Thank you for your interest and all the best. Stay healthy until the next one.